And for those of you that were at the leadership event, you're going to remember that Carl Daikeler trained on setting big goals and that it's totally possible to achieve those goals. Well, this next coach success story really is all about what's possible. Let me welcome to the stage Beachbody coach Emily Favre. All right, Emily, you've been a coach for 4 years, but let's start telling your story from the beginning.
So my story started out a little bit different than most. I was actually born drug addicted. So the day that I was born, they tested me, and I tested positive for meth, and I had fetal alcohol syndrome. So you could say the odds were not in my favor from the very beginning of my life. I was lucky enough to stay with my biological parents for 3 years until one day the cops came knocking on our door to find my sister and I was 3 and she was 4. We were completely alone in nothing but diapers. We hadn't been fed and we were basically abandoned. It was that day the cops came and took us away and we were never to be with our biological family ever again. But we considered ourselves the lucky ones because a few of our siblings didn't even make it out of that house alive due to the drug abuse. From there, we were put in foster homes. This might seem like a happy place for most people, maybe a safe place for kids that have been troubled, but for us, it was the exact opposite. My sister and I experienced extreme neglect and abuse, things no 3 and 4 year old should ever have to go through, or really anyone in their lifetime should have to go through. It was the hardest year of our 3 years of our life. But the third time's the charm, because it was in that third foster home that I was finally adopted and I was given a family. They had adopted 2 others, so I had 2 sisters, and they had 1 of their own, so I had a brother. We celebrated everything. I had happy Christmas mornings, I had birthday parties, and I had food on the table every single night. Things I so clearly remember being afraid I wouldn't have, so they're things I still to this day do not take for granted.
Awesome. So let's talk about before you became a coach. What was your plan before Beachbody?
So I had huge plans before Beachbody. I feel like I was one of those people that had it all figured out. I don't know if it stems from my rough past, but I knew from a very young age that I didn't want to fall into another statistic that most foster kids do. And I knew that I wanted to go to college and I wanted to get a degree. That was my biggest dream. And I still remember to this day telling my parents that dream because I wanted to be a sports reporter. And they said, that's great, but we can't help you financially. My parents did not have a lot, but they gave me everything that they had. But I remember feeling so devastated. But I also remember thinking to myself, Emily, right now you have 2 choices. You can let what they said just now completely determine your future, or you can go out and make it happen on your own. And so I did. I left for college when I was 17 years old and I didn't even have a car. And my first appointment with my guidance counselor, he said, Emily, what are your goals? And I said, my goal is to leave this university and graduate within 4 years. But my biggest goal is I want to leave completely debt-free, all done on my own. And I'll never forget what he said to me. He looks at me and he goes, Emily, that's impossible. And I left his office that day and I knew I had to do it because he told me it was impossible. And so for the next 4 years of college, I worked 3 jobs. I would move home in the summers to work and live with my parents. And on my very last day of college, I sat outside my English classroom and I paid my very last fee towards my loan. And I left school that day completely debt-free. First one in my family to ever go to college and to ever graduate college, and that was my biggest accomplishment today.
Awesome. So let's talk about when you became a Beachbody coach. So when did you become a coach?
So the time of my life I became a Beachbody coach was a very interesting time. I had just married my high school sweetheart, which was awesome, but he's also in the military, and if you're a part of the military world at all, then you know that once you sign those papers, you no longer have control of your life, where you go, or what you do, or basically anything. And we were told that we were going to be moving to the big state of Texas 2 months after graduation and after we got married. Well, 2 months turned into 7, military props, and it was in that 7-month period that my coach, Ashley Molstad, reached out to me, and she had seen my insanity results. I did insanity to get in shape for my wedding. And she told me 4 times you should be a coach, and I ghosted her all 4 times. I was that coach, well, that person that would ask her all the questions, figure out all the prices, and then not write her back. But it wasn't until the 6th month when I was ready that I reached out to her and I said, I don't want to coach, but I want to try the Shakeology stuff. And she got me with the, well, you know you can get a discount and you know it's free for military. So I said, sign me up. I left Oregon to move to Texas as a discount coach, and that is all I intended. But then I got to Texas, the big state of Texas, to only find out that we were sent to the smallest town in Texas called Del Rio. It was on the border of Mexico with nothing but a Walmart for about 300 miles, and you could see Mexico from our backyard. And I remember thinking to myself, Emily, how are you going to be a sports reporter in a town with just a Walmart? So that's when I decided to try this coaching thing. And I do not say try lightly, because that's all I did. I was a coach that would just hit Success Club and cruise. I wouldn't do anything else. I wouldn't try to advance a rank. And I did that for 2 years. And it wasn't until we got our 2nd set of orders to move to our next base that my husband said, you know, if you don't bring in more of an income, you're going to have to get a job. And I did not like the way that sounds. I'm an introvert and I love being at home. So I worked more, invited a few more people, and got more result, got more momentum. So by the time that we moved to Louisiana, I did not have to get a job.
Awesome. So let's talk quickly about 2017. What happened in 2017?
So 2017 actually started out great for us. My husband and I found out that we were pregnant. And at that time in our relationship, we had been trying to start a family for 2 years. So you can imagine how excited we were to finally get that positive test. But a few weeks later, I went to the doctor for a stomachache, only to find out that I was having a miscarriage. And we were devastated. I'm telling you, there is no worse feeling than looking up at that screen and not seeing a heartbeat when you should. And we just knew that we had to mourn, but we also knew that we had to heal. And so we did. And just as we started healing, we got pregnant again. We were excited but nervous, naturally, because we had another miscarriage. And another one, and another one. In 2017, my husband and I experienced 4 miscarriages. All babies that we wanted, all babies that we prayed for and hoped for, were taken from us without our permission, and it was the hardest year of our lives. No one could prepare you for that. And I was so depressed and upset. I thought to myself, how am I going to go on with my life if I can't even be a mom? It's something I've desired my whole life, and I can't make my husband a dad. And I would lay in bed in the morning and be like, God, give me something to get me out of bed in the morning, because I can't do it on my own. For months, I prayed that prayer. And that's when 80-day obsession came into my life. And I will never forget the day I heard about 80-day obsession, because I knew from the second I heard about it, it was going to be that answer prayer. I knew it. And I didn't know much about it all that, other than that it was 80 days and that scared the crap out of me. But I knew that was going to be the thing that changed my life, but it took me making a commitment to myself, and I'll never forget when I did that. I sat at the edge of my bed. It was a Thursday afternoon. And I told myself, Emily, right now you have 2 choices. You can go all in and let this completely change your life. You can kind of go in and kind of let it change your life. And I made a commitment to myself that day that no matter what the next 3 months threw in my way, I was going to give that program my all, because I owed it to myself and I deserved it after the year we went through. And we were just getting ready to start our fertility treatments, so lots of hormones. We also had a trip to Disney World planned, and New Orleans, and birthdays and barbecues, but I told myself no matter what, I was going to stay on track. And to this day, that was the best decision and commitment I've ever made to myself.
So how's your life different today?
Oh my gosh. Well, since making that commitment at the edge of my bed, I've lost 24 pounds. And I'm a better wife, I'm a better friend, I'm a better coach. And it's evident because we went from me being a solo diamond team, I was the only diamond, I had a few believers who believed in as much as I did. So now we're a superstar team. We have 19 personally sponsored diamonds. And the proof is that, and to me, it's people ask all the time, what did it? And it blows my mind because I think all the time, like, I had to go through the worst year of my life for people to see that a program can take you out of that. And I shared everything. When I wanted to run and hide, I shared it on social media. And you can ask my coaches now, they'll tell you that they watched everything. They thought that I would never come out of that depression. But seeing that a program like 80 Day Obsession can make me come out on top and better than I was before, that was inspiring. And I want you all to know that I've sat up there 4 different times. This is my 5th summit. And I would gather all this information, leave with a fire, and I want you to learn something from me. Leave with the fire, but don't let it go away. Don't let life get in the way and things get hard. You have to keep going, you have to keep showing up, and you have to keep being a product of the product. Something that I preach to myself every day and to my team is, you kind of sort of try, you kind of sort of get results with your fitness and your business. Thank you.
Awesome. Coaches, can you help me give one more round of applause for superstar diamond coach Emily Fowler?
Okay, well, she killed that.
Please welcome back to the stage, Jeff Hill.